Hey, Mickey.
Good morning, boss.
Good morning, Jim.
I received a bunch of calls about the shootings that occurred this weekend. We're gonna have to push the 11 o'clock back to 11:30. Are you gonna attend this conference next week?
You know what? I haven't had a chance to really look at it, so give me about 5 or 10 minutes.
Yes, sir.
We're working super hard out here to try to reduce this violence. What I promise you is that we won't be defeated. I mean, I promise this city that we won't be defeated. We won't be overrun by that small group, that small element that's committing these reckless acts. We will not. I promise you that we will not be defeated.
Today, a grateful city and a humble department honor and thank you for choosing a vocation of service. Chicago has recognized your sacrifice, commitment, and distinction as you walk across this stage to be formally named a Chicago police officer. Our city will also bestow the most important power that can ever be given, and that is public trust and confidence. Do not ever betray that trust. Chicago's my home. I grew up in Cabrini Green and was raised by a loving family who taught me the meaning of respect, the meaning of service, service to others, and the importance of trust. I'm not just here as superintendent, but I get to stand before you as a dad, watching my son follow my footsteps. Today is a day that none of us will forget. I'm incredibly proud of all of you all sitting out there. Don't ever forget that I wish you all the very best, and one day one of you all will be standing up here giving the address.
Jump on in, partner.
All right, what you doing here?
Well, you know I was an FTO for 7 years, so I think I know a little bit about this.
Oh, so I'm with you today?
You with me today.
Oh, okay.
Yep, you ready to ride?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, let's do it. It's a difficult job, but it's a good job. It's a noble calling. You know, you have to remember that we are partners with the community because everything we do ultimately goes back to that, right? And you have to think to yourself, well, I'll tell you this first. 90% of this job is finding a good partner to work with. But I will tell you this, and I'm telling you this as a father, not as a cop. Two things that you come on this job with, your honor and your integrity, are the two things you want to leave with. Because at the end of the day, we're here to serve the community. You know, you're a school teacher, so you're accustomed to helping people. You know, little kids are our most vulnerable population. People call us when they're at their darkest moments, you know, so we don't want to re-victimize a victim by treating them bad. All people want us to do is to treat them with respect and treat them fairly. If we do that, you'd be amazed at the love that the community will show you, because they want the police to police their communities. They just want us to be fair about it and be respectful. So what do you think so far?
I think this is a great job. I'm having a good time. My interactions with the community have been well.
Yep, and you know what, Daniel, I tell you this. The job should be fun. Now, you're gonna have some bad days, but the good days far outnumber the bad days. You know, and people ask me, even now after 30 years, because I came on in May of 1988, they ask me what keeps me going, and that's easy for me. Two things. I love to see when we're able to help somebody in the community and put a smile on their face. So that's, I get a kick out of that. The second thing, I get a kick out of helping police officers. The kind of job we got going on.
It's a 10-1 shots fired by the police.
7641 South Kingston, 7641 South Kingston, shots fired by the police and at the police.
You and his boss.
Shots fired at the police and by the police. 461 boy one team. 461 boy one team.
conducting a traffic stop. When they made the stop, the subject inside the vehicle fled. They saw a weapon. The subject then turned around, pointed the weapon at the officers, and fired several shots. The officers returned fire and were eventually able to place the subject in custody. A weapon was recovered. No one was struck. The subject wasn't struck. The officers wasn't struck. So a weapon was recovered. And now the investigation will proceed from there.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
And I heard you got an education as well, okay?
That's right.
Keep the spirit.
That's right.
Okay?
Yep.
All right, good luck to you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for being out here.
Thank you. Look what I have for you, too.
We got you. What you sorry to say?
You're welcome. How you all doing? How you get to be so cute?
Five.
You five? Did you get those pretty looks from Dad or Mom?
I know my dad my best friend.
Your dad's your best friend? Well, that's good. That's who should be your best friend.
You just met a real hero. You see that?
You listen to Dad, okay? All right, you all have a good weekend.
All right,
man.
Thank you. Nice to meet you.
Take care.
Thank you for showing up.
Thank you.
So, Daniel, I heard you and your dad responded to a 10-1 the other day.
They stopped a guy for a routine traffic stop. It was two mission cars. And I guess the guy took off running. The officers took off after him, and it turned into a shootout. You think traffic stops are routine, but anything can happen in reality on a traffic stop.
You know what? One thing you all have to remember, there's no such thing as a routine stop.
That's true. Who was driving anyway?
My dad was driving.
Well, you lucky. I rode with him. He never drove. One day I rode with him. Didn't drive. I'm driving. I pull up to the car. Debatably, he says I pulled up too far.
Oh, wait a minute. The reason I remember he was driving is because he put me right in the guy's eyesight. So he put me out the car right in front of the guy with the gun. That's how I remember he was driving.
He wasn't as fast as he used to be, so I had to get up a little closer.
Yeah, I was fast back then.
Okay. I'd like to hear from you guys, though. What made you get on the job?
I think being able to engage the community, similar to like when I was a teacher, but when I was a teacher, my focus was solely on mentoring the students, the scaffolding, helping them learn. But I think being a police officer, I have access to more information and more things that can help the whole family instead of just the student, you know? So, yeah, just being able to community police instead of just in the confines of a classroom.
I agree, these kids, I met a lot of troubled kids when I was working at the jail. A lot of them struggled because they didn't have family, they didn't have anyone to guide them. And this is definitely another way, before they get to the jail, I can go out in the community, I can help out and communicate and help them get to those places where they can be guided.
You know what, Daniel, I tell you what, one of the things I want you to take away from this is, remember the police-involved shooting we responded to the other night? And you saw the witnesses out there, you know, and I tell you, the relationships are so important because we need that information to bring these guys to justice. But, you know, unfortunately, sometimes witnesses don't want to come forward because, you know, they're afraid. Sometimes they don't want to come forward because of the retaliation aspect of it. But more importantly for us, sometimes they don't come forward with information because they just don't trust the police. And that's why it's so important. That's why I always talk to you about honesty, integrity, because we need the people to trust us. CPD is only as good as the faith that the community has in us. So we need them to give us the information so we can bring these guys to justice. And that's why it's so important that when we go out on the street and we interact with people, we're part of the community and not, you know, taking over the community. We have to be part of the communities that we serve.
It's a good opportunity now, better than ever with community policing and a lot of strategies, robust plans and strategies that we have. We're working on improving that trust and restoring public safety. But it takes work. It takes work. And those efforts that you guys give, you'll see it pay dividends. A lot of times people want to talk, but they don't know if they can talk to the officer or the officer's not pulling over. They feel as though we don't get out and walk. We don't get to know them. So we're making a strong effort toward turning that around. You'll find that the same thing that bring us together is the same thing that keep us separate. Officers that's going through the academy now include training on cultural awareness in their community. If you know more about the community, you're better able to assist in those problem solving. That's what community policing is about, problem solving together. I can tell you that we have programs that we hope that you all will get involved with in community policing. We have Explorers, Bridging the Divide. That program alone has been so phenomenal that people are requesting it because it gives people a voice at the table.
When I go out into the neighborhoods, people never say they don't want the police there. They just say they want the police to be fair and treat them respectfully. You know, and I think that's important for us to remember. You know, people want to be part of the change. They want to see change. But those of you out there that want to see the change, you have to be willing to be part of the change. So I want to thank you all for being part of that change and taking CPD into the next century. So a toast to your careers and being part of the change.